people, when I'd be on the road, people would ask me, said, you know, I'd like to learn to cook like you do, out of them Dutch ovens, you know, and have a ranch setting. So I got to thinking about it, decided that I would try to have cooking school in a setting that was just like any old cow camp that I'd ever been in. People come and they sleep in range teepees, and they learn to cook in an old Dutch oven, just like the way I did, just like old Cookie did many years before me.
Be sure and rotate your oven, Bee. Lid one way and the pot the other, so we can try to even out all the heat. You got one spot that ain't as hot as the other. And check every once in a while, Bee.
Oh, they're pretty.
Yes, they are, aren't they? Spreading out and growing sourdough cinnamon rolls. Yours is ahead of Jennifer's.
Ooh, hot legs.
Jennifer, we might even pull yours off a little. It's frying a little on one side.
Okay. The biggest mistake at school when people first learn to cook, because the first morning I give them biscuits and I don't tell them nothing, just tell them to cook. Too many coals is the first thing. They put too many coals under an oven or too many coals on top of an oven.
And you end up with something burnt pretty quick, and then they make the second mistake. After that, they don't put enough coals in. And different wood makes different coals, different variables in the amount of wind you have, the temperature it is, and the humidity all affects the way wood burns and what you're cooking.
Okay. All right.
You'll do two things a lot in cooking school. Make a lot of bread and wash a lot of dishes.
My partner's key.
You know, it's actually true. Bread and dessert are the hardest two things you can learn to cook in a Dutch oven. And if you can master the art of cooking bread and dessert in a Dutch oven, well, you'll be a pretty good Dutch oven cook. It takes practice, and more practice. They have thrown away so many biscuits by the time Saturday morning gets here that the coons and possums won't even eat them no more. Sourdough is our main staple that we make bread or dessert out of, and our sourdough blueberry turnovers or any pie filling you want to work are sure enough good, and we're fixing to make some.
The bottom of that, you have to You know,
I like for people to come in and they see a setting that you would, just like on any working ranch. When you come in there and there's five or six teepees pitched and no wagon set up there at the fly, and that old big wood stove of mine is putting out the smoke up there at the top of that old chimney pipe. And it draws them back to a different place and time. I wanted people not only to learn and cook when they come, but see our surroundings that were a simpler time in life. And let people learn that you can actually prepare any kind of food in a Dutch oven that you can prepare in the house.
How many times you done checked that bread?
A lot. I checked a lot, but you know what?
I told them you never look at them.
We're not feeding these good people burnt food.
Then Saturday we invite people to come in on graduation day. Students are used to just cooking one dish at a time, and that night on Saturday we don't tell them what they're going to cook till about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And then we divide it up to where everybody has at least two, sometimes three dishes to prepare all at once.
They get to feel a little bit of what me and Shannon have always had, and that is a little bit of the stress that goes with catering. They may feed anywhere from 15 to 40 people that night. And they get to realize that it's a little harder just to cook two dishes than it is just one. Then you throw in a different wood that we'll sometimes throw in on Saturday night that makes a different pole, and then you have a whole other variable. People get to feel about a little of the anxiety that goes along in Dutch oven cooking when you're cooking for a crowd.
You know, I always tell people I want you to learn something more than just Dutch oven cooking when you come to school. And we try to solve the problems of the world at times around that old fire at night, sitting in there by old Bertha drinking coffee. As she warms you up, you also find out that you can create many friends and you learn a whole lot about life.
Thank you. to cooking school, we hope that you have learned something. We hope that you've got a whole lot more friends than you had, and if you graduate, we'll even call you family. But it takes you back, like I said, to a simpler time, back when old Cookie was on the trail in the 1880s and 1890s.
And if you let yourself drift off there among them stars that you see at night, you can almost see these visions as you watch cowboys ride up the creek, coming to old Cookie when he rings the dinner bell. So if you've got a hankering to really taste the Old West and really know what it's like to come and learn to cook in a Dutch oven in an old cow cap setting, come visit me and Shannon.
For the mighty EMC, horses here for everyone. Saddle them, kids, let's get it done. By the time that Oregon sun goes down the south, it's history. This outfit.
History. So the MC crew, they rode them all, and the people all gathered around. One old boy gave $2,000 for banjo. A banjo took his trailer apart when he tried to load him up for town. Back in August, 100 and more. If you ever have a beer at the Adel store, say hi to Chuck and Nanny. Show you them big old steer heads up their hand. When you ask where have they gone, hell, they gone like the MC Cali. Back in August, 100 and more. So come on.